Hello, my name is Viktoriia Babicheva and I'm very excited to talk about our new article in Laser and Photonics Reviews, performing collaboration with Jerome Moloney here at the University of Arizona. First, let me tell you a story about writing this article. Well, there's no story, so let's continue. Optical resonances are relatively weak in isolated nanoparticles made out of commonly occurring materials with high optical losses, such as transition metal dichalcogenide, germanium, carbide, and other. The resonances are not sufficient for field enhancement and competing with plasmonic resonances in noble metal nanoparticles. Initially, we were puzzled what will happen in the case of material with very high optical losses, and that's how this research began. Our published work presents a novel approach to achieve strong resonances in the arrays of such nanoparticles with large optical losses. It points to their potential for efficient light control in ultra-thin optical elements, sensing, and photovoltaic applications. We show that one can efficiently excite resonances in the nanoparticles made out of material with high losses, and the interplay of excited resonances allows for directional light scattering from such nanoparticles. Let me briefly comment on traditional approaches for nanoscale light manipulation. Conventionally, we use either high-refractive-index or plasmonic materials to localize light at the nanoscale. In high-index nanoparticle, the light is confined within the particle, mainly because of reflection from material boundaries. In this case, most localization is still limited by diffraction. But for the very high material index, particle dimensions can be much smaller than the wavelengths of the incident light. In plasmonic nanoparticle, the light is mainly confined at the interface of material with negative permittivity, which is typically metal. In this case, the light can be squeezed in deeply subwavelength dimensions well beyond the diffraction limit. However, for plasmonic materials, optical losses are a big issue and prevent excitation of strong resonances in the nanoparticle. In the present work, we study nanoparticles made out of materials with a large imaginary path of permittivity, and we show that nanostructures of these materials support modes localized on the subwavelength particle. This approach opens up the possibility of exciting strong localized periodic nanoparticle resonances without involving materials with plasmonic properties or high refractive index. We call these resonances localized Zenneck modes in analogy to conventional Zenneck waves propagating along the interface where at least one of the materials has non-zero imaginary part of its permittivity. Arranging high loss nanoparticles in a periodic array plays a crucial role, allowing for collective array resonances, which are shown to be much stronger in a particle array than in a single particle. The collective lattice resonances can be excited at the wavelengths, mainly defined by the array period, and thus easily tuned in a broad spectral range not limited by particle permittivity, size, or shape. Materials with large imaginary path of permittivity commonly occur in nature, and in the present work we show the modes can be localized on a nanoparticle array made by patterning transition metal dichalcogenides layers of a thickness about 100 nanometers. In demonstrating realistic cases and practical applications, we focus on TMDCs. But nanoparticle arrays made out of other materials such as germanium, iron, tungsten, vanadium, chromium, titanium, and carbide can also exhibit similar optical properties. To sum up, we have shown that particles with a large imaginary path of permittivity support localized modes enabled only by the high optical losses, without the requirement of having plasmonic properties or high refractive index. Thank you very much for your interest in my research and watching this video.